morning. The time is 8:58 a.m. Saturday, 28th of August, 2021. The news headline. Steps federal government needs to take while Nnamdi Kanu and Sunday Igboro are in custody. The news in full. Nnamdi Kanu and Sunday Igboro have been at the forefront for the realization of Biafra and Oduduwa Republic. While Sunday Igboro fell into the hands of Benin Republic security forces while trying to connect a flight to Germany, Nnamdi Kanu, on the other hand, was repatriated from Kenya to Nigeria to keep a date with the judiciary. For Sunday Igboro, no one could precisely predict when he would be set free, as Benin Republic security forces are holding on to him on migration breaches. While the two agitators are still in custody, the federal government needs to take the following steps in the best interest of the country. Number one, promotion of unity among Nigerians. This is an opportunity for the federal government to promote unity among Nigerians. The government must be seen to be after the promotion of its citizens' unification. It is an opportunity for the federal government to bring together existing and potential agitators by engaging in activities that promote the unity of Nigeria as an indivisible nation. Government can achieve this noble objective by its actions and deeds in governance. Number two, security of life and properties. This is the best time for the government to secure the life and properties of Nigerians. Nnamdi Kanu and Sunday Igboro are the faces of the agitation, and now that they are in custody, is an opportunity for the government to reassure Nigerians that their safety is of paramount importance. Number three, employment opportunities. The government needs to provide employment opportunities for arrestive youth. Lack of employment opportunities is one of the major causes of hooliganism and banditry in the country. When the youth are fully engaged and preoccupied, they will not allow themselves to be used as pawns in a chess game. Number four, commitment to nation building. The government must use the opportunity to prove to Nigerians that it is committed to nation building. It is time to let Nigerians know that the government is serious about fostering peace amongst its citizens. Time to let Nigerians know that their interest is best served under Nigeria as a nation and not under any new republic. Number five, equity and fairness. One of the focal points of the agitators is the lack of equity and fairness of governance in governance. Now is the time for the government to remove the erroneous impression, and the government must be seen to be equitable and fair to all, irrespective of ethnic background. The government must use the relative peace being witnessed as a result of their being in custody to maximum advantage. It is time to right all misconceptions and false narratives. It is time for the government to prove to its citizens that their interest is best served under Nigeria as a nation. The time is 9:04 p.m. Good morning. The analysis. This is an analysis on what the federal government needs to do while Nnamdi Kanu of the indigenous people of Biafra and Sunday Igboro, the agitator leader for the Oduduwa Republic, while both of them are in custody. This is a suggestion for the federal government on things that they need to do while they are far away. Of course, Nnamdi Kanu for a while now has been at the DSSC facility after he was repatriated from Kenya in a way that is not legally allowed. And since then, he has been there, held in detention and not allowed to really have fair judgment and a case as it ought to be. We also learned of recent where the lawyers went to visit him, but they were
manhandled and harassed and embarrassed by asking them to put off their glasses, and also that they should withheld their writing materials, amongst other things, even asking them to remove their shoes. As Sunday Igbowo, on the other hand, by the Nigerian government, accused him of trafficking in arms, inciting violence, and disrupting the public peace while agitating for secession. And as a result of that, he actually tried to escape to Germany through Benin Republic, but he has been arrested at the Cardinal Bernardin International Airport, Cotonou, on a Monday while he was trying to catch a flight to Germany. And ever since then, he has been held in the custody of the Benin Republic, while the Nigeria government has been trying to repatriate him as well back to Nigeria. However, his lawyers were very fast, because we learned that the Olubadan of Ibadan sent some delegates to go to Benin Republic for the trial of Igbowo at the court department of Cotonou, just to make sure that Igbowo was not repatriated back to Nigeria. And it is unclear if the court, which is expected to pass its judgment, will discharge Igbowo or extradite him to Nigeria as requested by the federal government of Nigeria. Although the Pan Yoruba Social Political Organization Afeniferi praised the Olubadan for doing that, and also said that the immediate cessation of harassment and agitators of the freedom fighters is across Nigeria, same way they did to Nnamdi Kanu, and that this is just a way by the government, especially the President Muhammadu Buhari, of concentrating and hunting and harassing those who are seeking relief from oppressive situation in Nigeria, and shying away from tackling the menaces of kidnapping, terrorism, and attacks bordering on the ethnic, and cleansing them thereof. And its suggestions by this writer is that while they are away, it is an opportunity for the government to, number one, promote unity among Nigerians by their actions and deeds, and number two, an opportunity for them to provide security of lives and properties. And number three is that if the youths are fully engaged and preoccupied, they will not be allowed to be used as a chess game, or they would not be opportune to participate in any form of illegalism and banditry in the country because they are employed. And number four is that the government needs to be committed to nation building. They must convince their citizens that the Nigerian interest is best served when we are a nation and not when under any new republic. And the last one is that there should be equity and fairness while they are away. That one of the focal points of the agitators is that there is lack of equity and fairness in the government. And if the government can change the narrative while they are away, then the citizens of Nigeria will be happy and unite as one.